We are going to talk about meditation, and then after meditation we'll do pranayams. Now let us get it clear. First, what is meditation? Because this is very important to understand meditation before we proceed further. And normally we understand by meditation that concentration on something, on some thought, on some matter, focusing. That is what we call meditation. In that case, in our daily life, most of us are concentrating on various things. We have some goal, we have ambition, I have to achieve something. So we are concentrating on our goal. Businessman is concentrating on his business. He has to achieve his target. Students also, they are also concentrating, focusing on their studies. He has to attain his ambition. But in actuality, is that meditation? Is focusing on something, on some thought, on some ambition, some goal? Is that meditation? Meditation means it is a state of emptiness of the mind. Total emptiness in all levels of mind. It has been purged, it has been emptied out. Now what is this emptying out? What is the state of the mind now? Mind is full of thoughts. All the time human mind is thinking. Every moment they can't go beyond that thinking and thinking. In sleep also thought process goes on. All the time relating in terms of thoughts, with thoughts. Relating to matter, relating to property, relating to things, relating to nature, relating to people. All in terms of thoughts. And have we ever questioned, where does thought come from? What is the origin of thoughts? Where does thought originate from in the mind, pop up in the mind? What is thought? Throughout our whole life, right from the childhood, maybe at the time of inception also, when one is in the womb, he has been under influence, all thought influences, in the environment influences. Right from the beginning till today, whatever we have accumulated, whatever we have seen, we have heard, we have experienced, throughout our whole life, parents' relationship, friend circle, school, college, workplace. So everywhere we have been under influences. Now there is a lot of the surge of influence from all media. All the time they are bombarding the brain with different ideas, thoughts, different opinions. So all our minds, we are all full of those influences. We have filled all those things, our minds have been filled. And whatever responses we give to various situations, when you relate to people, we relate to situation, we relate to ideas, all arise from those thoughts. Those whatever we have accumulated, those past, those accumulation is the past. So our responses, with reference to any situation, are all from the past. So our mind all the time thinking from the past or accumulating from outside influences which are converted into thoughts, and we respond. Our opinions are formed from there. In fact, whatever our opinion, our observation, it is not our original. These are all second-hand, our acquired ones. So our mind is full of all those accumulations. So meditation takes place only when those accumulations of the past have been emptied out. Presently, because of all those accumulations, because of all those, we cannot remain at rest. Those thoughts, those accumulations of the past, all the time creating disturbances in the mind. I have to achieve this, I have to achieve that. I am here, I have to go there psychologically. It's time. Time is thought. I am here, I have to reach there. I have to achieve that. I don't have this, I have to have that. So time is thought. So these accumulations which never allow us to be at rest, in terms of thought we are forming all sorts of attachments. I am attached to my wife, I am attached to my children, I am attached to my car, I am attached to my properties, I am attached to my idea, I am attached to my ambition. The moment there is attachments, because in attachment there is security, there is satisfaction. So you all run for attachments, for security. But we have to understand, we have to see deeply that whichever gives us security is also the cause of concern, cause of problem, cause of pain. The moment I am attached to something, I have also planted fear in my mind. It cannot be other way round. It is any attachment, it will give only security. It's not possible. Wherever there is positive, there has to be negative. Positive and negative go together. Maybe we may deny that, but it is there. It is truth. Many people may not like all this, but it is the truth. We cannot deny it. It is not my manufacture. It is not my fabrication. It is like this. So, whichever gives me comfort, whichever gives me security, whichever gives me gratification is also the cause of suffering, pain, fear. These are all the handiwork of thoughts, the past. Man has to understand that the past which is moving through me, in which the wind, the wave of which I am caught, is the cause of all problems. It is the truth, it is like that. The very seeing of this, in actuality, that which gives me pleasure, that which gives me security, is the cause of all my suffering, all my pain, all the conflicts of life. The very seeing of this is freeing. One has to see that actually, without condemnation, without justifying, without saying right or wrong. Just see it as a fact. That itself is freeing. That itself is understanding. So in meditation, in actual meditation, in fact, there is no need to say actual meditation. In meditation, it is just freedom from all those whatever have been accumulated in my mind in terms of thoughts. That is meditation. Total silence. Absolute silence of the mind. When the mind dies to the past, that is the expression. That is absolute silence of the mind. That is when it is said that one is in meditation. Now, how, and that is when there is unfolding of the beauty of life. One who has gone into all this, understands meditation, has a relationship of life, relationship of love, beauty and joy. And in the silence itself, there is strength, there is energy. Because in that silence, all the energy has been accumulated. All the energy have been summed up. In thoughts we have been wasting our energy in conflicts. But in that silence there is summation of the energy. So there is tremendous strength. There is fathomless faith. In that, I am not there, you are not there. It is that energy, that